So we're going to get to now a question that can be solved using the fact that two functions that have the same derivative as each other differ from each other only by a constant. So let's if you've taken a calculus course before, you may recognize the term antiderivative or indefinite integral. We're not there yet. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just ignore the last 5 seconds. If you have, this is going to look a little bit like that. But for now, it's just enough to recognize that we know certain derivatives and should be able to recognize them when we see them. So here we have f prime of x equals 3 secant squared 3x, and what we want to do is find all possible functions that could be f of x. And then we want to find the specific function that is f of x if we know that f of pi over 12 equals 5. So first of all, what do we know about the secant squared function? We know that this is the derivative of the tangent function. So even though we'll cover the more analytical technique for finding this later on, hopefully you can recognize that if I set f of x equal to tangent of 3x, then if I differentiate that by the chain, then I would get secant squared 3x, and then by the chain rule, I have to multiply by the inside. That gives me 3 secant squared 3x. So this is a perfectly good candidate for the answer to A. The only thing is, the question asks for all possible functions that could be f of x, and this is only one of them. Recall from the previous video that if let's say this is one function that has a particular derivative, all the other functions that have the same derivative are just shifted up or down by a constant. So they're the same shape, but they're shifted up or down. So in other words, it could be tangent of 3x, it could be tangent of 3x plus 1, tangent of 3x plus 2, tangent of 3x minus a million. Any of these would be a legitimate answer. So the way we express that we're talking about all such functions is we write a plus c after it. So the answer is f of x equals tangent of 3x plus c, where that c can be any constant, and by writing it in the symbolic form, we're re representing the idea that it could just be any number and we could be shifting it up or down. So this represents all possible functions that could be f of x. Now, for b, we're given a specific piece of information that's going to allow us to choose one of the functions. Now, why is that? If you notice, all these functions, they just differ from each other by a constant, but there's only one of them that passes through that point. So if I know any one point on the function, I should be able to completely pick which one of these functions it is, which means I can just solve for c that way. So here, what I know is that f of pi over 12, which equals 5, must be, I can plug it into the function I found, that's going to equal tangent of 3 times pi over 12 plus c. So that gives me 5 is equal to tangent of 3 pi over 12 is the same as tangent of pi over 4 plus c. Tangent of pi over 4 is 1, so that means that 5 equals 1 plus c, so c is equal to 4. That means that the specific function I'm looking for is going to be tangent of 3x plus, I've now solved for c and it's equal to 4, so that's going to be f of x equals tangent of 3x plus 4. There you go.